This is BBC Two, and the time now is 2 o'clock.
Very good afternoon as you join us here live in the heart of London's theatre land. This is the new London Theatre in the famous Drury Lane. It's going to be our home for the next 9 days as we cover the State Express World Challenge Snooker Cup. Well, here with us are the 18 best snooker players in the world, and those 18 are representing 6 different nations, and they're competing for prize money of £31,000. Let's take a quick look at the format of the tournament. The 6 nations are split into 2 different groups. There in Group A, we've got Canada, Wales, who are in fact the defending champions, those 2 nations with exactly the same teams as they had a year ago when the tournament was held in Birmingham. And completing Group A, we've got the rest of the world, and in that team is Jim Rempe from the United States, the world pool champion. Then in Group B, we've got England, last year's runner-up, so with almost a completely new team this time. Australia, they've got Eddie Charlton in the team this time, and that'll be a force. And a very strong Irish team as well, a full Ireland team led by the world championship runner-up Alex Higgins. Well, each tie, in fact, is over 15 frames. They compete, first of all, on a league basis, and when we've got all that sorted out, it becomes a knockout championship with 2 semi-finals and a final. That final will be played tomorrow week, next Sunday. Well, the opening match today is between 2 nations who had a ding-dong battle last time, Wales playing Canada, and there's the formation of their team. Canada, with Cliff Thorburn, the world champion, Big Bill Werbeneck, the North American champion, and their very exciting Kirk Stevens. And Wales, well, their captain this year is Ray Reardon, 6 times champion of the world, Terry Griffiths, one of the most popular winners of the world title ever, and Doug Mountjoy, who's just had a marvellous win here in the Champion of Champions tournament in this very same venue. Well, the opening match, the one we're going to watch live in a second or two, is between Kirk Stevens and Doug Mountjoy. It's over 3 frames, and when they played last year over a 1-frame match, well, it was a real corker. It all ended on a re-spotted black. They had about 9 attempts to put that black down, and finally Doug Mountjoy did it. Anyway, today, as I say, they play over 3 frames. The players are ready in the wings. The commentators on the match here live will be Ted Lowe and John Pulman. And to introduce the players is the tournament MC, Bruce Donkin. Thank you, Bruce.
Thank you, David. And from Canada, challengers, Kirk Stevens. And representing the holders of the State Express Challenge Trophy from Wales, Doug Mountjoy. In charge of this first match this afternoon, senior tournament referee John Williams. Enjoy your snooker, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you.
And so we wait for the first ball to be struck in this year's State Express World Challenge Cup, and the holders, Wales, take the first ball in the shape of Doug Mountjoy. Doug's opponent over this first 3-frame match is the exciting player from Canada, Kirk Stevens. A young man we've come to know who wears the immaculate white suit.
Well, a near miss there from Doug Mountjoy, who, of course, is one could almost say drunk with success, because in this very hall last week he became the champion of champions, pulling off a wonderful victory.
Quite natural, I think, John, that these two players will take their time in this first frame, sizing the situation up.
Well, as I know very well, Ted, you know, you start off in a completely new situation here. Brand new cloth, brand new balls, brand new everything. And in fact, the worst sort of conditions that one could possibly play snooker under. Takes a little while to get used to the situation.
Your ball go down. This, of course, is the first of 135 frames in this particular tournament over the next 8 days. Each player has to play five particular frames. Maximum matches are three frames, which this particular match is over, and there are a number of single frames.
One.
And so the first ball of the tournament goes to the Welshman, Doug Mountjoy, champion of champions.
Endeavouring there, Ted, to split the reds up to advantage, but it didn't come quite as well as he might have expected. But has a red on in the middle pocket, I think it will probably take that and go down for the blue.
Nine.
As good as he could possibly hope for there.
14.
A little bit the wrong side for that ball. Leaped himself a long red into the top pocket, which, knowing Mountjoy, I think is probably no great problem. And
15.
Nicely on the black. Who knows, in this very first frame, one could see a good break coming from this. Well, once again, making a little bit of a hard work of the job. Didn't get on the red as he anticipated. He's now faced having to bridge over the top of the red for a red into the middle pocket. And beautiful play.
A very good shot that, John. Just shows this man's confidence.
Of course, the only problem, Ted, he hasn't left himself on a colour as he would have liked, but blew into the middle.
Well, the break goes up to 28. And once again, he's got himself in a little bit of trouble.
Yes, obviously, potting that red had to kiss into the other one. Could nicely have come onto the black had he been fortunate enough. But now, a little bit of trouble. I don't think there's a ball that he can pot. Although, knowing Mountjoy, he might stick this blue into the corner pocket, the balk pocket. Oh, he's played it in the middle. And what an effort.
Thirty-five.
Not quite far enough down the table. Struggling with almost every shot is Mountjoy.
A difficult situation again here. He's obviously going to play the blue into the middle pocket, but he's looking to see the red that he can possibly gun. Got to go into balk and around. Didn't make it. I would suggest we'll have to be a safety shot now, I would think.
40.
Possible chance of knocking this red into the corner pocket.
Oh, great shot.
But once again, a very playing a long blue into the corner pocket. But this break, every shot has been a miracle, more or less.
41, red.
A very nice 41 points then to the Welsh team from Doug Mountjoy. Interesting to note that in their match in this particular tournament last year, they played just one frame, and there was literally only 7 points in it in the end after a re-spotted black.
Kirk knocked the red in there, obviously onto the blue, into the corner pocket. We'll play to trickle this in for a red into the opposite top corner pocket. Unfortunately for him, the pink and black are a little bit hemmed in.
Six. Seven.
I think he played to get on the black there and may well elect to go for it. I didn't quite get on it as he anticipated. And we'll now be looking for a plant, two reds together.
14.
Into the top pocket.
15.
He's a bit unlucky there, John.
Yeah, well, because he always had the saver there, the brown that's on into the middle, which he obviously played to snick that one in. Come up the table onto the reds again. Oh!
Foul. Canada 15, Wales 4.
Well, just 30 points in it then at the moment. Still 5 reds to go.
Doug Mountjoy playing to knock this red. Oh, and what a great shot. Oh, beautiful. What a great popper this fellow is. Will elect to play the pink into the middle. Cue ball into balk and back up again onto the reds.
Seven.
And if he can see that red, it couldn't have happened better.
I think he can just get through to it, John.
I think so, yeah. That could well have been the frame-winning shot.
That first red certainly was the frame-winning shot here, John, without any doubt at all. Mountjoy now sailing ahead.
Looking there to see just exactly where he wants the cue ball to play a red across into the top pocket is to be judged to perhaps within a quarter of an inch. Not a lot of room to maneuver, but I think he's on it absolutely perfectly. The
22-year-old Canadian from Toronto, now requiring snookers. 61 points in it.
31.
35 points on the table.
32.
And just the right angle there, Ted, to stick this black into the top of it nicely on the yellow. And the rest of the colours should be, for a man of his calibre,
39.
Completely academic.
41.
This man has certainly started the snooker season in great form, John, hasn't he?
59.
And so the first of this three-frame match goes to the holders, Wales. Doug Mountjoy taking that at 111 points to 15. With still two frames to play. A total of some £31,000 at stake in this particular State Express World Challenge Cup, with £9,000 going to the winning team. John, this is a terrific amount of money for these players to be playing for.
Well, indeed. But this is snooker today, of course, Ted. I could reminisce, of course, and in the days that I had a few successes, one played for peanuts, of course, but this is great. There is that. And how well Mountjoy played in that frame.
Quite brilliant.
Man playing with extreme confidence.
Second frame.
Obviously.
Candidate to break.
And virtually didn't put a foot wrong in that first frame. But who knows? Two more frames to go.
And this time it's Kirk Stevens, 22-year-old Canadian. Started playing at the age of 10. Kirk, in fact, like the world champion Cliff Thorburn, has just moved across to England to promote his game, to get more competitive play than he can do in Canada. So we should be seeing quite a lot of this young man. So it's Mountjoy away again. Ray Reardon captains the Welsh team. The other player, of course, being the former world champion Terry Griffiths. Very formidable indeed. Like you and I, Mountjoy just checks that there is some chalk on that half bat.
I think perhaps he was looking, Ted, to see if there was a tip on it. Who knows? First time it's been used.
Always difficult to use that, John, that half bat, really, and he's played that extremely well to stay on the black.
Yeah, it's easier, I think, Ted, to sight the pot when you... But obviously, the equipment isn't as good as your own cue. And he's got a little bit straight on this black. Very difficult. If he's going to do anything with a cue ball, try to leave himself a red into the middle there, whether he's done it or not. I would doubt. Left the cue ball a little bit close to the black spot, and John Williams, our referee, is having a little bit of difficulty. In fact, I think he had to put the black a little behind the spot, but I don't think it would quite swap, leaving Mountjoy with a red into the middle.
17.
This man has won just about every major snooker title there is to hold except the world title.
Once again, a little straighter on the black than he would have liked, but there is one red left there, perfectly on it, the following corner, pocket.
30.
Onto the black, but now, with the next shot, must get on the black, I would think. He's looking to see if a red will go there, but possibly will try to get on the black at an angle where he can go into that little bunch of reds to split them open.
31.
Well, he's obviously gone for the red at the top of the pack there.
38.
Thirty-nine break again so far.
46.
Not quite.
46.
very useful 46 points then to Wales. Kirk yet to get off the mark in this second frame. Just to remind you, it's the best of three this first match. Each match, of course, represents 15 frames. That is between the three players, each player playing five particular frames. In some cases, they play three-frame matches, and in others, one-frame matches. Holders, Wales, represented here by Doug Mountjoy, have taken the first frame. Well on the way now for the second frame. Every frame, of course, most important. £9,000 to go to the winning team.
So it's Wales then off to a good start in the first of the nine matches that we play between these two nations in the opening tie of the championship. We have two more programmes from this New London Theatre here today. The next one is at 6:20, and that'll be the continuation, news of this match of course, and continuation of the other matches between Canada and Wales, the defending champions, in the opening tie of the league section. We hope you'll join us again
Wales
at 6:20.
Tonight's rugby special on 2 features Cardiff versus the All Blacks at Cardiff Arms Park.